Hello, buddy. It's Zechariah. As many of you know, I am dedicating my running training for all the fallen police officers, firefighters, and U.S. Border Patrol members who took life in line of duty in 2021. And unfortunately, tonight I'm running for another fallen officer who have lost his life in line of duty. Tonight I'm running for fallen officer Christopher Farrar. He worked with the Chandler Police Department in Arizona, and his end of watch was April 29th, 2021. He lost his life after he was struck and killed during a vehicle pursuit. This pursuit was a part of multiple agencies, and it was a huge pursuit that was happening at the time. He was 50 years old at the time of his passing, serving 18 years as a police officer. He leaves behind a loving family. Tonight, I'll be running with the Blue Line flag in his honor. I'll be doing 7 laps around the track at my school, which is the equivalent of 1 mile in his honor. Tonight, I'll be joined by many people, including the Seminole County Sheriff's Office, Oviedo Police Department, Winter Springs Police Department, who are patrolling, Seminole County Sheriff's Office, U.S. Customs and Border Protection, as well as a supporter who's actually doing an 100-mile challenge for Suicide Awareness Month. She'll be doing a mile in honor of a military hero tonight as well, as a part of the run. We're also joined by the Central Florida First Responders, Bagpipes and Drums, who'll be playing tunes during the run as well. Even though it seems like it's me and 3 others running, at the same time, there's even more running, and it's all the fallen I have ran for. I know they're all running in spirit tonight, including fallen officer Christopher Farrar. Before the run starts, I'm going to do a quick prayer in honor of his whole family and department through the hard time they are going through, and then I'll be on my way.
Those that are tuning in tonight, Zechariah now running his 2nd mile of the evening. This mile in honor of fallen officer Christopher Farrar. He worked with the Chandler Police Department in Arizona as end of watch April the 29th, 2021. Sadly, he lost his life after being struck and killed during a vehicle pursuit of a stolen vehicle that involved multiple agencies. He was 50 years old at the time of his passing, having served a total of 18 years as a member of the Chandler Police Department in Arizona. He leaves behind a loving family. Zechariah, along with many supporters here tonight, completing their first of 7 laps, which is 1 mile, to honor the life of fallen Chandler Police Department officer Christopher Farrar. Always very appreciative of the various local agencies that continually come out to help honor our fallen heroes alongside of Zechariah. Helping tonight to pay tribute to fallen officer Christopher Farrar, we have multiple members of the Seminole County Sheriff's Office, our home county agency, both patrolling behind and running with Zechariah. Also patrolling, we have a member of our home city agency, the Winter Springs Police Department, as well as neighboring agency, the Oviedo Police Department, running with Zechariah. We also have a member of the U.S. Customs and Border Protection, and as Zechariah mentioned, a individual that's in town that's also paying tribute to all fallen first or military lost due to suicide. Playing pipes tonight, we have a piper for the Central Florida First Responder Bagpipes and Drums Band. Again, we're here today to pay tribute to an 18-year veteran of the Chandler Police Department, fallen officer Christopher Farrar, who tragically lost his life on April the 29th after being struck and killed during a vehicle pursuit that involved multiple agencies. Zechariah now completing his 2nd lap. Every mile that Zechariah completes, he carries with him a unique flag, each flag sent to the family of the hero that he runs to honor. The flag tonight, a Blue Line flag, will get sent to the family of fallen officer Christopher Farrar, along with a handwritten note that Zechariah wrote earlier in the evening. If you'd like information on how you can be a part of this mission, please visit running4heroes.org. We're also going to do a follow-up post a little bit later in the evening with details on how you can be a part of this mission. I'm going to go silent on this next lap. I'm going to remain silent for the duration of the run as we reflect on the life of this hero. 18-year veteran of the Chandler Police Department, Officer Christopher Farrar. Our thoughts and prayers go out to his family. Our prayers also go out to everybody with the Chandler Police Department in Arizona and everybody in the surrounding communities that knew this hero, admired this hero, and worked with this hero. We hope this run honors him well. We thank him for his 18 years of faithful service to the Chandler Police Department. Zachary, any final words for the family of fallen officer Christopher Farrar?
To the whole family of Officer Christopher Farrar, everybody with the Chandler Police Department in Arizona, and everybody in general going through a hard time, I hope this run means as much as possible for everybody over there in the Phoenix area and the Chandler area. Just 1.5 years ago, something like that, I went to Arizona, and I met lots of, 5 months ago, just over a year ago, I went to Arizona for an event, and then for a separate event, I also went 5 months ago. So I know I've been to the Phoenix area 2 times, and I've met lots of people there. I appreciate just all the support that I have over there, and I bet there's lots of people going through a hard time knowing that Officer Christopher Farrar passed away just a few days ago on the 29th of April, 2021. So my prayers are with everybody over there through the hard time they're going through. And if you're part of his loving family, this flag I remember tonight, the one you're looking at, is going to be sent to you as quickly as possible. This blind flag, it'll be sent to your location, as well as a handwritten note that I've already written, and it's ready to be sent out to your area. When you receive the flag, there's no preference on what we want you to do with it. But whatever you do with it, we will find comfort every single time you look at it, knowing that your fallen hero, Officer Christopher Farrar, will never be forgotten down here in Florida and throughout the whole entire United States of America. Final words from you, a true hero and who deeply loves community. Just like the 21-gun salute, if all of you tonight would like to join me in a 21-second moment of silence, each second day can be one amazing thing he had during his life, including in law enforcement. Please do, during this 21 seconds, you do not know how much it can mean to the family through a hard time they are going through. Thank you all very much for joining that 21-second moment of silence. Now, of all of you tonight, would like to bow our heads one more time tonight, this time in a prayer, for Officer Christopher Farrar, as well as Deputy Terry Dyer, who we ran for tonight. Dear God, unfortunately tonight we've had to come out here to do 2 more miles, both for fallen law enforcement officers, 1 deputy, 1 officer, both from different areas, 1 from Tennessee in Madison County, Tennessee, and 1 all the way over in the West Coast in Chandler Police Department, Arizona. Both of these heroes lost their life from separate events, but both of these events, heart attacks and being struck and killed, are two of the most major things that we have lost our first responders from this year that's not COVID-19 or gunfire. And unfortunately, we lose so much every single year from both of these passings and both of these types of deaths. And it ruins departments, ruins communities, ruins families, because it's usually unknown when a heart attack or, of course, being struck and killed by a vehicle happens. God watch over both families. I know the first run I got to actually meet the daughter, and I get to see firsthand who I'm running for tonight, and I bet the second run is the same thing. I hope the family and the whole department gets to see it, and if any people are going through a hard time and have not seen this run yet for their fallen first responder, God guide them to this run so they can find just a smile in this 10-minute tribute run. God, I truly believe one of our many angels on earth are our first responders. God, watch over all of them, because I really hope any angels on earth in the next few days become an angel in heaven with you. I know in the last few days, over the weekend and coming on a Wednesday now, we've actually have lost none that were added in the line of duty. God, it's been quite a few days since there's one been added. So just watch over all first responders, and let's hope that streak continues for as long as possible. God, thank you for keeping me healthy as possible, and as I'm reaching 900, keep me safe. I hope, even though we're just 3 miles away, I hope I never have to reach 900. But unfortunately, if the time comes where we do have to do another few miles in the next few days, God, keep me safe and healthy so I can continue honoring many families who are going through a hard time. Thank you again, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you all very much for joining me in these 2 runs tonight. I know it does mean so much to the whole department and communities if you did just join us in these 2 runs tonight. Hope you all have a great night and stay safe as well, especially for your first part of working tonight. Thank you all again for watching, and I pray God blesses you all.